So it's so crazy to be here so early in Sunday morning, no? No? I hope you bring your cup of coffee before, because it will be intense talk about OCI registry, how to use this OCI registry beyond the use of container image storage. So the agenda for this session will be first something about the brief overview on OCI registry, the specification and images, and then I will have a look on how to use this OCI registry to store something else than artifact, than image, like image from to artifact, and how to integrate them into your supply chains, and I will apply it to a use case on AirGap environment. So before diving into the topic, I'll introduce myself. I'm Stefan Estegracias. If you want to contact me, you can use this handle at Estegra. Basically, I'm a cloud native enablement catalyst at ITQ, a European consulting company that focused on multi-cloud solutions. So I enable to connect organization, people, and platforms to bridge the gap between the technology and the business. Additionally, I'm proud to serve as a CNCF ambassador to develop and advocate the cloud-native technologies, and as well to supporting the growth of our community. So let's first have a brief overview of OCI registries in the usual use case to store container images. So OCI means Open Container Initiative, and there are three specifications that define how container technologies are specified. So first, the runtime specifications defines how where the runtime operates, the container operates, sorry. And then we have the image specification that defines how images are organized. And finally, we have the distribution specifications that defines how to serve these images. These two images and distribution specifications have been updated last month to promote the use of something else than container images. But I will go there later on in the presentation. Before that, I will just remind you some terminology used on OCI registries. First, the registry itself. So registry is a service that implements HTTP API endpoints to pull and push images from and to. Then here you have a usual URL used. Sorry. A URL used by, by registry client. Sorry, I was perturbed by the upload, sorry. So the registry URL here, the usual one. And the first part of this URL is the registry itself, so it's the server hostname where the service is running. Then you have the repository that contains all images you would like to have for a specific application, so you have multiple versions on the same repository, so it represents a namespace for grouping these images. And then you have a reference. Usually this reference is a tag because it's human readable. We are human, we cannot read digest like this because it's too long, and is for the unicity and immutability of the image to use this digest. You can, most of the time, on the registry client, use both tags and references, digest like this, but remember that when you use this, only the digest is sent to the API of the registry. In the coming slides, I will go through the topic there, so manifest, the manifest, then config, blobs, and layers. So first of all, when you try to find something in your registry, you find back by with a tag, so you use this API with the name of the repository, then tag list to get the list of the tags contained into this repository. Then a tag effectively points to a manifest. We'll see just after what is the manifest. And to find this manifest with the endpoint, you use this endpoint with the namespace, the name of the repository, slash manifest, slash the name, the tag. And you will get a JSON document that represents an image manifest. So you have media manifest. one, two, three. Yeah. Okay, it's okay. So in the registry, you have an image manifest, you have multiple parts. So the first one is config. The config points to a config blob inside the blob storage, and it's pointed by its digest. So a blob is the binary form of the storage of the images, and the config represents the configuration that the runtime used to run the image. Then you have layers part, so you have multiple layers most of the time, and here a layer is pointing to each layer points to a layer via its digest, and you can combine these layers to create the full file system for your container image. So let's see an example with specific images. Here, the Kubernetes API server image. You see how to dump it, the JSON, the image manifest, so it's a JSON document with image manifest, and you retrieve all the parts, so the config part with its digest and the layers. So here, I only represent one layer, but there are more than one in that case. So here, I just remember you how OCI registry is working. Now let's dive into how to use this OCI registry to put artifacts on it. So first of all, some projects already use OCI registry to put artifacts into the registry. For instance, some tools like Signatures tools or SBOM tools use the same repository to store data into the OCI registry. And they use a well-known tag to retrieve them back to the from the registry. Another solutions as well to store in OCI registry is to use a specific repository for a specific usage like mchart or OPA bundle. And in the new specifications, you have the ability to be more specific on what you would like to implement. But most of the implementation that has been done before is being applied to the specification. That means that the image manifest is used to reference the content, even if it's not an image stored, and it uses layers to store the binary content of the artifact. And you can use an artifact type to be more precise on what you would like to present into your OCI registry artifact. And one feature that is very interesting, and I will demonstrate later in this presentation, the relationships between artifacts in the same repository. You can use an additional keys named subject that can manage the relationship between artifacts, and to query these relationships, a new endpoint, referrers, has been added as well. To demonstrate, I will use ORAS CLI, so ORAS means OCI registry as a service. So let's put some stuff into the OCI registry. So we have a content, so it's a file. I would like to push into the OCI registry. To do so, I'm using here a test namespace, a very basic YAML file, because we love YAML file. And then push it with ORAS push. So it's a very straightforward command, and you can imagine that you can just have to set the URL you would like to push into the registry. So here is ORAS test repository with V1 tag. For identifying this artifact inside the registry, you have to set the artifact type. Here is a fictive one I invented, and pass as well for every file you would like to push in this command, the name of the file plus its MIME type. After pushing this artifact into the registry, you get back the digest of the image manifest. And if we dump this image manifest, you will see that is exactly what we expect from the specification. It's an image manifest, as usual, with config and layers part, plus artifact type that the one I passed in the command before, and the layer type of every file. You see the YAML type I put in the command line before. So the artifacts are exactly the same, stored exactly the same way as image. And the difference is that the media type used in image manifest are different. To get back this content from the registry, so it's ORAS pool, that's very straightforward, and the URL to use to push it, so ORAS test V1. And Horace will download the file for you and extract it on your current directory to retrieve the content you pushed just before. So it's not so complex to push whatever content into OCI registry. But let's go further by pushing more content into the OCI registry. Let's sign the content. So here is not very relevant because it's only a YAML file, but let's assume we have another content here. So let's sign it and push the signature into the registry. And because we have a new behavior of relationship between the content and another artifact, we use these relationships by attaching the signatures to the content. To do so, I will create a signature, a very, very strong signature, you see here, but let's assume it's a valid one, just for the demonstration here, and use Horace attach command to attach this to the registry. But before attaching, Horace will push the signatures and then attach it to the URL I put here in the command line. And as before, you need to pass an artifact type, so here is still a fictive one for the signatures, and the type of the file I pushed. After pushing to the registry, I got, as usual, back the digest of the image manifest corresponding to the signatures. And if we dump the signature manifest, you see that it's still an image manifest, as well with media type, artifact type and the layer media type, exactly the same as a spice in the CLI. And on top of this, you get the subject part that references the content I pushed just before. Remember the command I typed just before to push the namespace file? I got the digest of the image manifest, and it's exactly that it is pointed by the subject. So here, it will present the relationship between the signatures and the content. So now, how to get back these signatures by only knowing the name of the URL of the content you pushed. It's easy because you have now discoverability of artifacts that are in relationship together. So we use Horace discover command with the URL Horace test v1 that represents the namespace YAML file. And Horace will dump you all the relationships he found. Here, exactly the signature I pushed. So remember, when I pushed the signatures into the registry, I got an image digest. And then this is the same as the one I get back by using Horace discover. And I can pull, I get back the signatures from the repository, yes, with the exact digest I got from Horace Discover. And Horace will download the file for you and extract it in your current directory. So you see, you can have relationships between artifacts, and you can retrieve easily one from others. So it's not the same way as the two used previously with a well-known tag. Here, you don't need to know the tag of the signatures or the SBOM to get it back from the OCI registry. You just have to use the URL of your own content. So let's continue to push stuff on the OCI registry. We will create a software bill of material of this content, so and push it to the registry and attach it to the content itself. So it's very similar to the signatures. So here, assume is the valid SBOM. So SBOM usually is the catalog of the component in the content. So here is a JSON file. I will attach it to the content, as before. And then I have to pass artifact type. This is a fictive one as well for the SBOM, plus the name of the file and the type of this file. After pushing to the OCI registry, you know the story now, you will get back a digest from the image manifest, etc. So I won't show you the image manifest because you know exactly how does it work. And for those who are not focused, let's wrap up where we are. So we create a content, and we sign this content and create a SBOM for this content and push all of them into the registry and create relationship between the signatures and the content, and the SBOM and the content. So let's be crazy more, create a signature for the SBOM. Because we need security and for the security on your pipelines. So I would like to get these SBOM signatures into the registry. So what I will do is to push it and attach to the SBOM, because the signature of the SBOM is related to the SBOM itself, not the content. So it's why I'm using, as before, signatures, so the same signature as before. So let's assume it's a valid signature and push it by using ORAS attach command line. But here, instead of using the ORAS test v1 reference, I'm using the one coming from the SBOM pushed I execute before. So you see, here is exactly the digest I got when I pushed the SBOM into the registry. And then, like usual, for ORAS, you need to pass the artifact type and the type of the file you pushed to push this into the registry and create the relationship between these SBOM signatures and the SBOM itself. So now we have everything in the registry I want. Now, how to discover these relationships by using a simple command. So remember, the command for ORAS to do so is ORAS discover. But here, I will put only the URL of the content. And to get the hierarchy of this relationship, I'm using the option O3 that will show a tree like the tree command line for the file system. And the result is like this. And to follow the hierarchy, I just will put here the bottom right, the diagram I show you in bigger screen. To follow this. So first, you have the content with the image manifest of the digest, the signature, the SBOM attached both to the content and attached to the SBOM signature. So as I said, it's quite easy to manage content into the registry, and you can push whatever you want into the registry and put relationship between them, and you can retrieve easily by using only the URL of the content. But now, how to integrate this new artifact into your supply chain? Let's assume here is a usual GitOps supply chain. So developer creates the code, push into the Git. It triggers a CI pipeline that will scan test and create an image that is pushed, a container image that is pushed to OCI registry, and an M chart that is pushed to a chart repository. Then the platform team creates platform configuration, push it to the Git repository, and then bootstrap the platform with the GitOps operator, such as Argo CD, Flux CD, or Rancher Fleet, to get the operator to pull the configuration from the Git repository and install the platform to get the application ready to install. So application definition follows the same. Application code is stored to Git repository, and the GitOps operator will pull information from the Git repository to install the application into the platform. But how to move this artifact into OCI registry to get OCI registry as a single source of storage? First, Helm chart. So Helm already supports OCI registry to push it there. So I will get here, I will fetch cert manager bundle and push it to OCI registry with the Helm command, so Helm push with here the URL of the dir name of the repository. It's something weird with Helm push command. You don't put here the full repository name, but only the dir name, because Helm will add for you the name of the chart as the completion of the repository and use the chart version as a tag. And you will get. And because you push on OCI registry, you get back a digest of image manifest. And if we dump this image manifest, you will see this is an image manifest, again, with specific media type for M configuration and for the layer, the M tarball, so exactly the chart content into the layers. To use this with M, you can use this command you use usually with M upgrade install. But here, use OCI URL instead of the name of the bundle, and then use the version parameters as usual to pass the tag. So you can move easily configuration chart to the OCI registry. And because both images and chart are OCI artifacts, you can implement the workflow I just presented you to enforce the security and create signatures for both. So now we have to move all the GitOps operations into OCI registry. To do so, I will use FluxCD because Flux is capable to push Flux configuration into OCI artifact, OCI registry. You use flush push artifact command line to push it to the OCI registry. I'm use some variables coming from the Git repository where the Flux manifests are stored. I pass the path from for the manifest I'm using for Flux. And as usual, when you push something on OCI registry, you get the digest of the image manifest. And if we dump it, you will see it's still an image manifest, but with specific types here for Elm, for Flux config and Flux content that represent the files I put in the path. I pass to the command line. And to use it from the GitOps controller, you just have to replace Git repository by OCI repository and pass the parameter of the URL and the tag as you want. Then that means the workflow I presented can easily transition to this one. So the platform configuration is stored on Git and can trigger a CI pipeline to build, scan, and as well add signatures to increase, to enforce the security, and push the artifact into the OCI registry. And then the Flux controller, the source controller, will fetch the content from the OCI registry. And the same for application definition. You can enforce as well the security by sign everything you push on the OCI registry and fetch, pull everything to your platform and install the application. So now, how to manage to see it into your air-gapped environment. Before going through the registry ops pipeline, I will just remember you how does it work for the GitOps way. So here is the GitOps supply chain. On the air-gap environment, the delivery, the deployment is totally disconnected because air-gap is isolated from everything. So here, you need to create a relocation bundle. But in that case, you need to relocate many components coming from OCI registry, chart repository, and Git repository. Move the bundle to your isolated environment. And for this solution, you need to create an OCI registry server, a chart repository, and Git server to receive all the components and unpack from the bundle. So you need to install, manage, and operate those three servers in the isolated environment, and the operation from the GitOps operator is the same. With the registry ops solutions, it's even easier because you only have one type of content, OCI, component like images, artifacts, and signature, and everything is the same for the air-gapped environment. The deployment phase is totally disconnected from the production, so you need to create a bundle. But the relocation bundle here is even easier to create because everything coming from OCI registry, the image, the Flux artifact plus the signatures, move it back to your move this relocation package bundle to your air-gapped environment. Here, you only have to install a single server, the OCI registry, to unpack everything. You don't have to think about where to put whatever tarball you create. You push everything on your OCI registry. And because you put signatures on every artifact, you can verify them before applying to the cluster. So you see, this means that you only have to only one way to store images and artifacts, only one way to sign images and artifacts, only one way to validate image and artifacts. So OCI registry is very convenient to have a single source of storage for air-gapped environment to be more flexible in updating the platform. So let's wrap up what we see today in this presentation. So I showed you that we can push whatever content into the OCI registry, and since the version 1.1 of the image and distribution specification, it's now generally available for every application to implement it. So with Horace, you can do so to create your own content, but I'm quite sure that many other applications will implement these new features in the future. I see Notation, for instance, has an issue ongoing for the next release. And regarding the air gaps, using the registry ops is quite easy to use because you only have to manage one type of content, OCI registry, to install in the air gap environment and pack everything. And because you increase the security by applying CI pipelines to sign your artifacts, you can verify them before applying in your cluster on the gap environment. So if you have any question, I will be available all the day to speak with you. Or if you want to contact me, you can use that code as well to do so. I would like to thank you as well, the organizer and the sponsor for this event, and thank you for your attention.
Hello. Thank you for the talk. Question on the validation when you're in the air-gapped environment.
Yes.
What does that look like? What does that validation process look like?
So if you use Flux, you can use validation for the manifest using Cosign, for instance. And in the next version, you will be able as well to use Notation to validate this. For images, you can use OPA or Kiverno to validate the signature, I guess. For OPI, I'm not sure, but Kiverno, I'm sure. And Notation and Cosign on the Sixtor project are mostly used to sign the artifact. And the first Sixtor Cosign only use the well-known tags for now. I don't see the roadmap of this project right now. But for Notation, I'm more aware about this because Flux will implement it in the next release, and Notation as well in the next release will implement by default the new specifications of OCI images and distribution.
Yeah, something else I was curious about was the relocation bundle. I've never operated an air-gapped environment before, but I'm super curious as to, is there like a standardized tooling for creating a relocation bundle and that?
A good question. So I found two main tools. So there is no standardization yet, as far as I know, but there are some tools that try to ease this for you. So there are one named Zarf that do the relocation for you and as well the delivery. And there are the new ones coming from, I don't remember the name of this one, is a new coming from the Rancher side, the Rancher security part is start with H, but I forgot the name. I can remember back and tell you what the name of it. It's something that can pull everything from the registry, create a local registry in your file system, and push them into the AirGap environment. And that tools as well can act as OCI registry in the AirGap environment as well to bootstrap the cluster. Auler, yes, this one. Thank you for reminding me.
Do you have any experience with local registries like Harbor, Zot, any recommendations what you would use?
So usually in our customer environment, we use Arbor for all the artifacts. Here for this presentation, I'm using Zot. I'm using Zot since the 2.0 version. It becomes more stable, and the 2.2 version just released a few days ago, or yesterday, I don't remember, or Friday. And for Zot, I have no experience on production. I'm using it to see how does it work and how can be transitioned to productions, because Arbor is is good for production, but if you like to create a single or small environment, it's quite huge. And Zoot is very convenient to create very small environment because the footprint of Zoot could be very, very, very small. So I like this project, so I'm following to see how this goes.
Okay, great. Thank you so much, Stefan.
Thank you.
Really great talk.